Hello everyone. In this class, we are going to learn about the bisection method. In the previous class, I have already explained what are different types of equations and also about intermediate value theorem. If you have not yet watched those videos, I'll mention the link to those videos in this description of this video. Make sure you go through that first. So there are different types of equations, and algebraic equations or polynomial equations is one type of equation, and there are various methods to solve it, and one such method is bisection method. So as I told you in the previous video, I have explained about different types of equations and different types of methods that are available to solve this type of equations. So for algebraic equations, we have direct methods and indirect methods. Under direct methods, we have various methods, out of which bisection method is the most simplest and easiest method, and also the time consuming method. Now we will see how to solve a given problem using bisection method. First we'll see the procedure, and after we see the procedure to solve a question, then we will solve a couple of questions which were asked in previous year's question papers. We also will be discussing the varieties of questions that comes under this category. Now first let's see what is a function. This again I have explained earlier in videos. Let y equals to f of x is a function. Okay, so here x is the independent variable and y is the dependent variable, and it is dependent on x. So let y equals to f of x is a continuous function. Here when we say root of a function, it means that value of x for which the value of the function becomes zero is called as root of the equation. Means if f of x1 equals to 0, then x1 is called as root of the equation. So what is the root of the equation? So what is the purpose of all these methods is to find these roots. We are going to use these methods, various methods, to find root of an equation. So to find, when we try to find this root of an equation, when we are solving it manually, like linear equations, quadratic or cubic, biquadratic, any types of equations, when we are solving it manually, we will know what is the procedure to solve it based on the degree of the equation. But when we are using system, when we are using applications to solve such types of problems, we will have to write a generic algorithm or one particular algorithm which works for all types of degrees of equations. So that is the purpose of learning all these various numerical methods. Now bisection method steps we shall see. So y equals to f of x will be a given function. So first step is we need to estimate, or we need to find the interval. We need to find the interval a comma b where the root lies. Okay, where the root lies. And how do we find it? This is done as per intermediate value theorem. It is also called initial value theorem. So what is intermediate value theorem and how to find the interval? I have explained it in another video. So just for your understanding here, quickly I'm going to say, I'm not going to explain what is intermediate value theorem. I will just tell you how to find this interval a comma b. So we are going to put values for x randomly. So we will take f of x and we will take randomly different values for x. Let x is equal to a, let x is equal to b, like this we get different values, and then we will find what is f of a. Okay, so for these values of x, we will substitute that in the given function and we will find out the function's value. Suppose the function is positive for one value and negative for other value, then a root lies between the interval a comma b. So we need to choose such values for a and b so that the function's value will have opposite signs. It has to be for negative for one value and positive for another value. So when we say negative and positive, it does not refer to the signs of x. It refers to the sign of the value of the function after substituting that value in place of x. Once we get negative and positive, it means I have explained in detail with the help of a graph. So you can refer that video. You can right now see at the top of this screen, you can see the link to intermediate value theorem. And I have also mentioned the link in the description. You must watch intermediate value theorem video in order to understand this. We will write that that is how we are going to find the interval a comma b, and we will write that since f of a into f of b is less than 0 or f of a into f of b has opposite signs, the root lies between the interval a comma b. So this is how we are going to write our first step. So after finding the initial interval, see, sometimes in the question they will give the interval. If they give the interval, the step one is not necessary. If they don't give the interval, then we will have to find out interval using intermediate value theorem. So now after choosing this, next is find approximation to the root. Okay, find approximate root C is equal to A plus B by 2. So for bisection method, this is your formula. C equals to A plus B by 2. Basically, what are we doing here is we are dividing the interval into two equal half, and C is the midpoint of the interval A comma B. Suppose this is A and this is B. We are finding value C, which is the midpoint of A comma B. So I have determined in the first step that the root lies between the interval A comma B. Now every time I am going to find the midpoint of the interval, and I will decide whether the root lies in AC or whether the root lies in BC. So this is what I am going to find, and every time the formula is applied, we are reducing the size of the interval by half. And this way, when the interval keeps reducing a lot, finally we will arrive at the most approximate or the most closest possible solution. So find approximate root C equals to A plus B by 2. So now this is your midpoint or the first approximation to the root. And find f of C means we will find what is the value of the function at this midpoint. At x equals to C, what will be the value of function? So based on, so what is step 3? If f of c is equal to 0, then x equals to c is the root of the given equation. Otherwise, else choose a comma c or c comma b as the next interval. So we are going to choose which is our next interval. Means we have divided the interval into two equal half. Now I am going to discard one of the half and I will continue with the smaller interval size. And which interval I have to choose? It is based on intermediate value theorem. Based on the theorem used in step 1. Or you can write based on intermediate value theorem. Okay, so based on this theorem we are going to choose. So what is that? Based on this theorem we will choose is, I had taken for example that function is positive here and negative here, right? Suppose f of c is positive, then I am going to choose these two, positive and negative, no? So I am going to choose interval as c comma b. Suppose the function is negative, then I will choose this two. I will choose A with C because I have positive and negative. So based on the sign, we are going to choose the appropriate interval for our next round of the same process. Now after choosing this interval, repeat through step 2. Means once I choose the interval, again I am going to find the midpoint of this. See, we are finding initial interval in the first step. In the second step, I am finding midpoint of the interval and I am checking the value at that point, value of the function at that point. If it is not 0, usually it won't be 0. If it is not 0, then I have divided the interval into two half, right? I am going to choose either this half, or I'm going to choose either this half. Means I've reduced the interval size to half. Now again I'm going to find, now see we have to repeat through step 2. Means again I will find midpoint of the smaller interval now. Means this we are further dividing into 2 equal half, right? After finding this, we will find value of the function at this point based on its sign, whether it is positive or negative. I am going to choose either this interval or this interval based on the sign of that particular midpoint. So this procedure will be repeated for the given number of times. Sometimes in the question they will ask you perform 3 iterations, perform 5 iterations, means you have to do that many number of times. So this is C1 equals to A plus B by 2. Next we will find the next approximate root, which is C2 equals to A plus B by 2. So when I write A plus B by 2, basically after choosing the new interval, this is A and this is B. Okay, so that's how we are going to take, or in general you can just write it as the midpoint of the interval. So this process needs to be repeated for the given number of times. Now, the question can be asked in two ways. One is, they might ask, the question can be asked as, perform 3 iterations. They will give an equation. You have to find the initial interval and then find the midpoint. Do it 3 times, okay? The procedure you repeat 3 times. After third time, that is after finding C1, C2 and C3, after finding C3, whatever value you get, you write that as the answer. So this is one type of question. So another type of question is, obtain root accurate to 2 digits. So when we say that we need a root that is accurate to 2 digits, it means you have to keep continuing so many iterations such that the 2 digits after decimal point between two C values is same. Say for example, here you are performing 3 iterations. Suppose your interval is 1, 2. So initially you are going to get C1 as 1.5, you will find f of C1 something, and then you will find C2, suppose 1 and 1.5 if you take, you will get 1.25. Again if you take 1 and 1.25 as the interval, you are going to get 1.125. Okay, so you have done 3 iterations, finally you are going to say that this is your answer, assuming that you are considering only the first half of the interval. Okay, so the interval depends on the sign. Here I am just showing you the example. If they ask you perform 3 iterations, this is how you do. You find up to C3 and then you say that approximate root for the given equation is 1.125. Suppose the question is given like this. Obtain root accurate to 2 digits. Then you cannot stop at this stage. See here, after decimal point, the number is 2. Here after decimal point, number is 1. You have to keep continuing until the two numbers after decimal point are same. Say probably C4, you might get 1.1125, something like this. Okay. Now, see here, this is 1 and here also it is 1. Means now the root is accurate to 1 digit. Again, you find C5, which is 1.1089. I'm just showing an example. Suppose C6 is 1.1075. See now, first 2 digits after decimal point were same. So it means now your answer is accurate to 2 digits. So you can write, if the first 2 digits after decimal point are same, then you stop it and you write the approximate root as 1.10. So the number of iterations that you will require, if they ask answer based on accuracy, the number of iterations required will be more. So see the marks allotted. If the marks allotted is 6 to 7 marks, then it is fine. Suppose the marks allotted is something like 3, 4 marks or even maximum 5 marks. Then to make sure that you will, you arrive at this solution quickly, what you have to do is start with the smallest possible interval. Okay, when you are taking A, B, start with smallest possible interval so that you get the desired accuracy as soon as possible. Instead of 6 iterations, maybe in 4 iterations itself, you might get the desired accuracy. Now, how to be sure that my interval is smallest possible size? So to be sure for that, as I told you, if it is number of iterations, you don't have to bother. You need to bother only if it is based on accuracy. So how to find is, when you are choosing this positive and negative values of the function, make sure those values are close to zero. So suppose you get 1 here, and suppose the negative value is -16, suppose, then this is close to 1. I'm going to consider A as one of the interval points, interval endpoints. But the other value, I'm not going to take B, because when I substitute B, f of b is -16, means it is very far from 0. I want a closer value to 0. So what I'll do is, instead of say, I will take some in between value. Okay, so suppose x is 1 and this is 2. I will take a value 1.3, because 2, when I substitute 2, I'm getting -16. So I'll take 1.2 or 1.3. And if I get negative value for that also, say something like -5 or something, then instead of interval 1, 2, I'm going to choose interval as 1, 1.3. Okay, so here see, this is positive and this is negative. I am going to take these two pairs of values, 1, 1.3. If you observe here, the interval size is 1. Here the interval size is 0.3, which is less than half already. So you don't have to do this many iterations. With the lesser number of iterations, you get the answer for desired accuracy. Okay, so the procedure is simple. Find interval such that for two values of a and b, the values of f of x will have opposite signs. If the question is based on accuracy, choose smallest possible interval. Otherwise, choose values like 1, 2, 2 and 3, such that it's easy for your calculations. And then keep finding the midpoint of the intervals and keep reducing the size of the intervals and perform the number of iterations required or asked in the question and obtain the result. Okay, now let us see how to solve questions on this. I have already copied 2 questions from previous year's question paper, and we are going to solve those questions right now. Right, so this is one of the question where obtain approximate value of the smallest positive root of the equation by using 3 iterations of bisection method. So there are certain things that you need to observe here. They have given smallest possible positive root. It means don't take negative values for x. X can be negative. X cube is there, no? It can be negative. So when we are trying values randomly, like x equals to a and x equals to b, we can also try values like x equals to -1, +1 and all that. Since they have given positive root, let's not consider the negative values for x. Let's take only positive values. And we are supposed to perform 3 iterations only. Since it is based on number of iterations, you don't have to bother about the function's values being nearer or close to or far from 0. Okay. Anyways, we are going to choose that it is going to be positive and negative for 2 subsequent values. But still, since it's number of iterations, you don't have to worry too much about the initial interval size. Now let us write, and the presentation of the answer is very important. Write, let f of x is equal to x cube plus 4x minus 12. Mark this as equation number 1. Now let x is equal to 1. So what will be value of f of 1? You're going to get 1 cube plus 4 minus 12. So 1 plus 4 is 5 minus 12 is -7. And then I'll take x as 2. Randomly you can take values. F of 2, 2 cube is 8 plus 4 2s is also 8 minus 12. 8 plus 8 is 16. 16 minus 12 is 4. So I'm not going to check any further values, because here it is negative and here it is positive. So since function values have opposite signs for x equals to 1 and x equals to 2, the root lies between the interval 1, 2. This is how we are supposed to write. So write, since f of 1 and f of 2 has opposite signs. Opposite signs. So you can write like this, or since f of 1 into f of 2 is less than 0. See, if it has opposite signs, means 1 is plus and 1 is minus, and when you multiply you get negative, which is less than 0. You can write like this also, f of 1 into f of 2 is less than 0, the root lies in the interval a comma b. Sorry, the root lies in the interval 1 comma 2. Now this is our initial interval, and which is found based on intermediate value theorem. So what is intermediate value theorem? For two different values of x, if the function gets opposite signs, it means for an in between value of between this 1 and 2, function will have a value 0. That is, when it is moving from negative to positive direction, it has to cross the x-axis where y is equal to 0. That point of x where y is equal to 0 is going to be the root of the equation. So to find that, I am taking an initial interval here, 1 and 2. So in between this 1 and 2, we are going to have a value, and for that value, the function will be 0, which is what we are supposed to find. Anyway, this is our step 1. We have found the interval. So what is next step? We will find the initial approximation. We will write first approximation to the root. First approximation, write it fully. First approximation to the root is equal to C1, which is a plus b by 2. Okay, you don't have to write a plus b by 2. Just write 1 plus 2 by 2, which is 1.5. Now, let us find what is f of 1.5. So, find 1.5 cube 3.375 plus 4 into 1.5 is 6 minus 12. So, we will get 3.375 plus 6 minus 12 is minus 2.625. And this is a negative value. I have to choose values of x and y such that f of x is negative for one value, positive for another value. So here right now I have got negative 1. It means from the previous interval I am going to choose value of x for which function was positive. So here I will write, since f of 1.5 into f of 2 is less than 0. The root lies between 1.5 comma 2. See, to understand this, sometimes it will be little confusing. You can write it using a number line. Okay, so initially we took 1 and 2, and f of 1 was negative and f of 2 was positive. Next we find the midpoint, which is 1.5, and f of 1.5 is negative. You have to choose negative with positive, means opposite signs you have to pair it. Now negative with positive we need to choose, so write 1.5 comma 2. Or other, if you don't want to write this, then see what is negative and positive here. Here I've got negative. Previously negative was there for 1. Replace that 1 with 1.5 now. And make sure you always write smaller value first when you are writing the interval. Don't write 2, 1.5. Always write 1.5, 2. Okay, so it has to be smaller value than the bigger value. So first approximation to the root is done. It means first iteration is done. We have to perform 3 iterations. So now let us find the second iteration. So we will write second approximation to the root is C2, which is midpoint of the present interval, 1.5 plus 2 divided by 2, which is equal to 1.75. Now let us find what is 1.75. F of 1.75 is, first we need to find 1.75 cube, which is 5.3593 is there. Then plus 4 into 1.75, which is 7 minus 12, is 0.3593. See, now this is a positive value. See, previously I got negative for 1.5 and now I have got positive. Means these two only I have to pair. Since f of 1.5 into f of 1.75 has opposite signs, or you can write is less than 0, root lies between, always remember to write smaller value first and then the bigger value. Now second approximation is also done. Now find the third approximate root. So third approximation to the root is C3, which is 1.5 plus 1.75 by 2, 1.625. Now let us find, you actually don't have to find the third one, but still we will find f of 1.625 to make sure whether it is root or not. So 1.625 cube is 4.29105. I will write 2911 plus 4 times 1.625 is 6.5. minus 12 is minus 1.2089. Now we have completed all the three iterations. So after three iterations we will write therefore the approximate root is x is equal to 1.625. So after third iterations we are getting x equals to 1.625. we are going to write this as our approximate root. Okay, so this is after three iterations we have performed, and if you observe, the answer is actually not even accurate to one decimal digit. After the first decimal point itself the value is different. It means the accuracy is not even one digit, but we can't help. We have to continue with this answer because they've asked us to perform three iterations. Now let us solve the next question, which is also similar. They have an e function given and we are supposed to use bisection method, and here also we have to perform three iterations only. So we will write the answer quickly. Here I'm not going to write the answer detailedly. I'm not going to write. You can refer to the previous solution for detailed presentation of the answer. Here I am just going to find the solution. So let y equals to x cube minus 3x minus 5. So this is our first function. So let's write it as f of x. Okay. Then let x equals to 1. F of 1 is 1 minus 3 minus 5, which is minus 7. Then I'll take x as 2. So f of 2 is going to be 8 minus 3 2s are 6 minus 5. So minus 11 plus 8 is minus 3. Then I'll take x equals to 3. Why am I taking third value is because after finding two values, I see that both are negative only. I need function to be negative for one point and positive for other point. So I'm taking for f of 3 also. F of 3 is 3 cube is 27 minus 3 into 3 is 9 minus 5. So minus 9 minus 5 is minus 14. So 27 minus 14 is 13. So now you see here I've got negative answer and here it is positive. Therefore the root lies between the interval 2, 3. If the same question was asked based, if they have asked to find the answer based on accuracy, I will not start with 2, 3. Since when I put x equals to 3, I'm getting f of 3 as 13, which is very far from 0. So actually I'm going to find out x is equal to 2.2 or 2.4, something like that. And then I will find some other closer value, closer positive value. But since here it is a number of iterations, I'm going to continue with this interval itself. So here I'll write since f of 2 and f of 3 has opposite signs, root lies in the interval 2, 3. So here I'll do first iteration. You can even write it as first iteration instead of writing first approximation to the root. C1 is equal to 2 plus 3 by 2, which is 2.5. Now find f of 2.5 cube is 15.625, and then it is minus 3x, minus 7.5, minus 5 is 3.125, and this is a positive value. Okay, since it is positive, now you see earlier we had 2 for which the function was negative. Now for 2.5 the function is positive. So I am going to write, since f of 2 into f of 2.5 has opposite signs or less than 0, root lies in the interval 2, 2.5. This is your first iteration. Next we will perform second iteration. C2 equals to 2 plus 2.5 by 2, which is 2.25, and we will find what is f of 2.25. 2.25 cube is 11.3906 is there. I will take 11.39 minus 3 times 2.25 is 6.75, minus 5 is minus 0.36, which is negative. Since it is negative, previous one is positive, we are going to pair these two values. Okay, write, since f of 2.25 into f of 2.5 has opposite signs or less than 0, root lies in the interval 2.25, 2.5. So second iteration is done. Now it is third iteration. C3 equals to 2.25 plus 2.5 by 2. You get 2.375. You can actually stop at this stage, or just in case, 3 rounds you fully complete. So 2.375, we will find the cube, which is 13.39648 is there. I will try take 3965, minus 3 times 2.375, which is 7.125, minus 5. So 13.3965 minus 7.125 minus 5 is 1.2715, which is positive. But you don't have to write the next interval because we are not going to do the next iteration. So you will have to write the root lies in this interval because these two functions are of opposite signs, only if you are continuing one more iteration. Since here you are stopping, so we don't have to write it. So you can write after 3 iterations, approximate root is x is equal to whatever you get, C3, you know, that you write 2.375. So this gives you 6 marks. Hope you understood. So as I told you, suppose the question is based on accuracy, then don't start with this value. So you can take x equals to 2.5 in this case, because 13 is very far, take some in between value. Minus 3 is close to 0 compared to 13, so don't take even middle value. take some value that is close to 2 because minus 3 is close to 0. So instead of 2.5, I would take something like 2.3 or 2.4 and we get a value that is even lesser than 3.125. So that is going to be the positive value. Therefore, we will start our initial interval itself with 2 and 2.3. So like this, when we do, maybe in third iteration itself, you might get an answer which is accurate to one digit. Means after decimal point, the first digit might be same. So further two more rounds iterations if you do, maybe you will get the second digit also same. So once you get the second digit after decimal point same, then you can stop and say that this x is equal to, this is the root approximate to two digits for the given function. Okay. So this is a bisection method. We have many other methods like Regler-Falsi method, Newton-Raphson method and all that. So subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so that whenever we post a new video and whenever we conduct live sessions for placements and coding and all that, you will get notifications. And share this also with your other classmates and keep watching for all the other methods. If you want specifically any particular method or any particular subject if you are looking for, make sure that you mention that in the comment section. We will try to post a video as soon as possible. And in our videos, in most of the videos, we will mention the best books in the description section. So that is actually an affiliate link. So when you purchase a book through that link, we will be getting a very small amount as a commission. So if you are looking out for purchasing any books related to this subject, you can also have a look at the link provided in the description. Okay, see you in the next video. Bye bye. Take care.